it's not my job to succeed. It's my job to do my best against the greatest threat ever to face humanity. I'm guessing that 10 days from now I'll be commencing a hunger strike. Duration, I can only guess, somewhere between 30 and 50 days, probably closer to the 40-day mark. As far as I can tell so far, I'm not called for it either to be fatal or likely to be of permanent damage, although there's the risk. It appears my kidneys have not recovered. The edema is back in fairly full blossom. I've not regained the body fat that I had before. My digestive tract has not recovered. Most significantly, the much lower body fat will mean that I'll not have as much onboard food supply as I did last time, bringing much closer to the threshold of brain damage and organ failure. Some other significant risks versus the last one of several months ago, the 50-day one. I suspect that I'll refuse all calories this time. Calories were not my goal last time, but I allowed myself two electrolyte packets per day that were 20 calories each. The calories were incidental, but I suspect I'll forego that this time and do not have ready access to zero calorie electrolytes. I do expect to take vitamins again this time. I do not expect to allow myself the bouillon cubes, which were almost entirely just salt, but 10 calories each, as I recall, each of two servings per day. So salt and electrolytes are not something that I envision providing for myself. I've noticed on the internet that zero-calorie electrolyte drinks are available. Powerade Zero is available, but it's certainly nothing that I expect to procure for myself, particularly because I suspect that this one will be a 23-hour-a-day occupation of the park. I perceive that's a way to amp up the commitment, amp up the potential impact of my effort to refuse to leave the park for more than an hour a day, and I suspect most days I won't leave at all. If I can get away with it, I'll do some reclining late at night. I think that may work out. But here in the park, as opposed to leaving for more private, more comfortable places as I have been. Of course, without taking any solids, my bathroom requirements are such that I should be able to avoid leaving the park most days. I am contemplating purchase of a solar panel that will give me some power during the day, although unless and until some people emerge to charge my laptop overnight, that will be severely curtailed, unfortunately, but that's how it is. I expect to do video logs, although I feel that what service I can do the world, and more particularly the few, the proud, the nonviolent warriors, the information I left on hunger striking, on both the theory, the physical aspects of the last hunger strike, cover the bases quite well. I suspect I will be doing a video log for those that care to access it. I suspect that whatever efforts I did last time to promote, to send outbound information, will decrease significantly. More and more it's clear to me what my job is and what my job isn't. By God, I'm a nonviolent warrior, and my job is to do certain parts of the fight, and it's a tremendous disservice when I spread myself too far, giving the illusion that I can do other people's parts as well. Whether it's attending to my physical needs for electrolytes and sodium, or powering the laptop so I can stay informed, and post video logs and things of that matter. I'm a soldier. Soldiers in Iraq and Afghanistan have their focus. I have my focus, and if the rest of the team isn't there, it's not my job. It's not my job to try and compensate for promotion, moral support, team building, funding, leveraging it to other organizations, leveraging it to inspire other organizations, and on and on and on. Not my job. Showers. Not my job. And every day, every week, every month, I get more comfortable with that. I'm one cell in the body of humanity, born and to be born. It's not my job to do other people's work. It's my job to do my work, and I'm pretty perfectly comfortable with taking the outcome of that. I am totally unwilling to sit on the sidelines and not do my job because other people don't do theirs. Oh, Start, you'll get hurt. Oh, Start, you may have organ failure. Oh, Start, you might die. We're condemning billions forever to living on a dying husk of a hellish planet. What happens to Start matters? No. No, not in the scheme of things. Nor does it matter what happens to you in the scheme of things. What matters is that we devote our lives to the totally doable task of securing the future for humanity, which in another 18 months will not be there. If we don't turn this upcoming election into not some meaningless exercise of determining who the next captain of the Titanic will be, but rather turning it into an unviolent commandeering of the Titanic away from the coal and gas lobby, to a failure is not an option plan to reduce our use of coal and oil 80% by 2020, then the game is over. We need all 8 years to effect the totally doable technological implementation. Carving out an area the size of Rhode Island in our southwestern deserts for concentrated solar plants using today's technology, melting salt so that there are both sunlight hour and non-sunlight hour power. Continuing at a much faster pace to implement much sought after wind towers on Midwest farmland. The farmers love it. Breaking the barriers, really the only significant barriers, which are the right of ways for the smart grid to distribute that power. Entirely doable, friends. Damn every adult alive today if we don't stand up and turn this upcoming 2012 election into a decision to give our children the kind of prospects for a habitable planet that all of we adults have enjoyed.